Good morning, everyone, and a happy Wednesday morning to you. Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I am Bernadette Roberts, a member of the RevivalTime Assembly Church in San Fernando. We are a member church of the Pentecostal Assemblies of the West Indies. Today, I will take you into the letter O, order. We are often told, get your life in order, do things orderly, put some order to your room, and in the legal system, order in the court. That word order is pretty much utilized, I must say. So what is order? The dictionary tells us that order is the arrangement of things in relation to each other, according to a particular sequence or pattern. In relation to people, order can mean the authoritative command, request, or instruction given by someone, like one's superior, a boss, or a parent. God's divine order is submission to His Son, Jesus, and His Word, commandments, and the divine order of the Holy Spirit. Divine order implies that there are boundaries we should not cross. There is spiritual authority that we must and should respect. There is a proper way for things to be carried out. Divine order brings divine peace. Divine order is asking what to do through prayer and then trusting and allowing the process to take place. God is not a God of disorder and confusion, but of peace. But how do we follow God's order for our life? 1. Be in constant prayer. 2. Read God's word. 3. Obey and follow the commands God lays on our heart. 4. Seek friends and community that align on a similar path like ours, who will encourage and support in God's plan for your life as you pursue your goals. 5. Submit your whole and entire self to God and trust Him to order your daily walk. Those who allow God's word to order their steps will not live in a manner that displeases God. God's discretion in His word gives us comfort and confidence to keep us on track and avoid the trappings of this life. Psalm 119 verses 2 and 3 state, "Blessed are those who keep His statutes and seek Him with all their heart. They do no wrong, but follow His ways." Psalm 32:8 says, "I will instruct you and teach you the way in which you should go." God knows exactly how to get us to our destination and keep us on course. It is us who feel we can do all things our way and deviate from God's plan for us, thus causing chaos and confusion and setting doubts in our minds. If only we would let God have His way and see it through without complaining, maybe we will be more successful as a people. God is completely willing to be there for us once we ask for His help and guidance and leave it to Him to see it to completion. One of the clearest signs that God is ordering your steps is if He starts to speak to you directly through His word or other people. If you feel like God is consistently speaking to you about a particular thing, then it's very likely that He is trying to orchestrate your life in that direction. God orders our steps so that in the end, what we do with His commands for and to us will bring further glory to Him. It might not always feel good, but that does not mean it is not for our good. God's word is truth. Romans 8:28 states, "And we know that for those who love God, all things work together for good, for those who are called according to His purpose." How do you view God's divine order? More importantly, how do you view God's authority in your life? If you believe that God is good and trustworthy, and wants only the best for us, as a parent would want for their children, then God is calling on you to submit to Him and to His will today. Let's bow our hearts in prayer. Sweet Holy Spirit, we pray that you will guide us, lead us, and empower us to experience a life ordered by God, so that we can have a fulfilled existence, basking and living in the glory of your presence. Order our steps to better serve you in spirit and in truth. Help us to be obedient to your commandments and receive the spiritual benefits that will come our way. Amen. See you tomorrow.